Good morning once again. Welcome to Why in the Morning. And today is on Tuesday. And as we all know, Tuesday is all about business entrepreneurship. So we're going to our first guest today. And he's a very interesting man, a man who has employed over 2,000 people so far. Farason Gishovu, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for hosting me.
Okay, you're welcome, Sana. So you're a housing contractor and the CEO of Pacific Realty Investment.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about your story, ulianza aje, where you started.
Okay, thanks a lot for hosting me today. My name is Farason Murithi Gichovi, CEO of Pacific Realty Investment, a company that deals with construction of affordable housing and also development of affordable housing. My journey in construction industry is an interesting one, whereby I started like 8 years ago. The first year, as any business person tell you, you not get business.
Mm-hmm.
So it demanded a lot of what we call perseverance and waiting to get the client.
Yes.
And then you get the first customer, you make what you call the baby steps. You either make losses, you make mm-hmm. profits. So I would say from when we started, I started the company single-handedly, running the show, being the foreman, being the, you know, the operations and the accountant in the same industry. Then we got our first customer, whom we did a house for. Then the good word spread there that we are doing housing at affordable rates.
Okay.
And that's where we are able now to get other customers from what you call referrals.
Uh-huh.
So currently we pride ourselves as one of the best contractors in housing.
Yes.
Then for the last 2 years consecutively, we have won the best affordable housing contractor in mm-hmm. Kenya. Yeah.
Okay, so where are you guys located? Where is your location?
Our offices are in Roy Town. Roy Town. Roy Town is around Kangudo Road,
mm-hmm.
Please call the Dune Plaza, next to Lake Oil Petrol Station.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to find us on our social media, we are on www.pri.co.ke.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then also we have a very active Facebook page, Pacific Elite Investment Limited.
Mm.
Yeah.
So why housing? Why not any other business? What motivated you? What made you like say, this is what I'm going to do, this is my dream?
I would say first I did my first house when I was not in the construction industry, and there are some many challenges that I faced from the bureaucracy, from the system that we do approvals,
yes.
And then also fundis, the masons and the cashews, and a lot of challenges on the same aspect. And then also it happened, my first employment, when I finished high school, I was one of what you call the vijana wa mjengo. So I had a few experiences before I went to campus.
Uh-huh.
So I did mjengo for like 2 years consecutively,
uh-huh.
In site,
yes.
Being like a site boy and everything.
Uh-huh.
So I also had that experience.
Yes.
Then after campus,
yes.
I went to a different route. I went into hotel industry.
Uh-huh.
Then again, after going to the hotel industry for like 3 to 4 years,
yes.
I found myself in a construction company where I started as a messenger.
Uh-huh.
So I was able to learn the ropes about construction the same.
Uh-huh.
So based on those challenges and what I started previously, I was able now to focus in construction. And then also I saw a niche in the affordable housing segment, because as you have seen, even the government is spreading the word about the what you call the affordable housing currently, or agenda 4. Yeah.
So you didn't study for like construction, university, college, or kwenda kusomea construction?
No.
Why not?
I would say sometimes before you find your path,
yes,
you might go into many ways. So for me, I did business administration. I never did construction. But then also my family, I would say like my dad has been a mason for quite some time. So I think I found the passion from there. And then again, also after also involving myself in construction, seeing what is happening on the construction industry, I was able to run the ropes through the process. And then after trying a lot of business, I've done a lot of businesses. This was a business that I was able now to find my route.
And what's your starting capital like? What did you start with? Ulianza na pesa nyingi, kidogo, hapo katikati?
For any business,
yes,
I would say capital should not be the big issue. What you need is the drive, the passion, and then also to meet customers' expectations, and then also to do what we call like you provide solutions to problems. So I would say when I started, I didn't have that much capital. Just did an office setup. And then from the office setup, you're able now to advertise yourself through social media. And then again, once you get the first work, that work, if you do it well, it will sell you. it will give you more opportunities in the industry. And then once you, the company starts growing, you also need to also to uphold trust and integrity in the process that you do. Okay. So I would advise our young people that you don't need capital to start any business. What you need is the passion, the goodwill, and you see the perseverance, and you'll make it.
Okay. Yeah. So tell us about Pacific Realty Investment. Yeah. What do you guys deal with? What are you about? What differentiates you from any other business?
At Pacific Realty Investment, we provide what you call one-stop a shop for construction services. We have a team of professionals ranging from the architects, the engineers, contractor surveyors, electrical engineers, mechanical engineers, and then now the masonry, the roofing team, the interiors, every aspect of construction. So when you come to our office, let's say for the first time, you meet with the project manager. Project manager will take you through what maybe you want. You want a bungalow, you want a mansion, you want a commercial development. So we take you through all the processes. Like now we say like the inception process is to know what you want. We put it on paper, we draw for you. We assist you in getting the county approval processes. And then we do the actual construction for you. And our construction process is also done in phases, whereby once the house is complete, we give you what we call a turnkey. We give you a complete project. People will be able to check on our website and our Facebook page. They'll be able to see all those processes. Then again, once we complete the house for you, we give a warranty for 1 year, at least to make sure that just in case there is anything that you need to be done on the house, we are able to come back and check on it. We also advise you, because there are some people who buy land in places that you cannot be able to do either permanent houses, or maybe you bought a land where it was maybe a dumping site. So when you come to us, we have a team that goes to the site to do what you call a physical site visit. They do the preliminaries, and then we advise you accordingly. Then our cost is also based on the taste and preferences of the customer. But I would say we are the cheapest at the market local level. So we're able to give you the best in construction.
Mm. Yeah. Okay, you've mentioned so many things that need so many people to do them.
Sure.
So I'm just wondering, how many people did you start with, and how many workers have you employed right now?
I would say when I started, as I said earlier, I started alone.
Yes.
Then as you proceed, now you find there is a need to employ an architect. There is a need to employ an structural engineer. So in our company, let's say like permanent employees are the professional guys who have done engineering, architects and everything. So we have a team of more than 40 guys on that segment. And then also now we have what we call now field guys, like the casuals, the masonry and everything. So any given time, the minimum that we get are like 1,000 employees, and sometimes we even go to an extreme of doing 2,000 employees. And then we cover the whole of the Kenya. And recently, we also started a project in Southern Sudan. So we have done a very big project in Southern Sudan.
Mm-hmm.
And then any county in Kenya, if you go to Kisumu, if you go to Budarangi, you go to Marsabit, you'll find Pacific. Yeah. Mm.
And what are some of the challenges that you faced when you started, and even right now, where you are?
We face a lot of challenges as business people. One is that when you start a company, people to trust your brand. That's one of the challenges. And even banks to support you. I always say that banks always want somebody who has taken off. They don't want somebody who's trying to take off from the ground. So you find when you are looking for the finances in the banking industry, you get a lot of challenges. Number two is finding the right employees to be able to propel your business, because construction is like a train. You need a lot of cabins. As I've said, there is a lot of teamwork that is needed. So getting a right employees is a challenge. And then another challenge we face is the institutions, the government institutions. Like for us, we are registered by all construction bodies. But then let's say when you want to do the approval for any building, we face a lot of challenges from the bureaucracy of the county government, those processes. You know, when they come to do the inspections, they have a lot of challenges of corruption and everything. Another thing that we face is what we call infrastructure. Because you find most of Nairobians own plots, but then again they cannot be able to access their plot because of due to poor road network. There is no water, there is no power. So we face those challenges as we are in this business of construction.
Mm-hmm.
But you're hoping the government will be able to at least check on these issues. The other thing is also financing for our customers, because construction is also, I would say, is capital intensive if you want to put up a house. So most guys were like in formal sector. Currently, they don't have somebody who can be able to finance them to do the construction. We do a lot of bank projects as well. People who are in employment, they're able to take that advantage of what you call construction mortgage.
Okay.
But then we have now people who are in informal business who lack the capability to be financed. Mm. Yeah.
So if I wanted a house built, yeah. Am I the one who is going to go and look for the fundi? Am I your company will provide me with everything from the start till the end of the house that I want?
As I said earlier, we give one stop. Once you come to us,
okay.
Give us an idea. This is what I want. This is the budget that I have. We shall provide you from design, approval, and the actual construction. So the only thing that you need to do is just you sit back, come and watch your project as it takes shape.
Mm-hmm.
So we ensure that we give all the processes and we build for you up to the stage of finishes. Now, as a customer also, we also give you a chance to make what we call a taste and preferences, because any project, we say they are unique. Every
yes.
customer is unique with their needs. So what we do, we have an application in our office whereby if, like now, we have a 40% of our business which are diaspora guys who are not in Kenya. So for them to be in touch with their project, we give them what we call daily updates. And then when it comes to the stage of the finishes, you, the client, will give you a chance to choose the materials you want for the finishes, the kind of paint you want, the kind of roofing sheets you would want, those things, the lighting, everything. Because this is your project, we are not selling a house for you. Yeah.
So if I wanted a house, that does that also mean that the land, am I going to get advice from you guys about where I want to build? Am I can come on board with my own ideas? Yes, how does that happen?
Mostly, I would say bulk of our customers, they own land.
Okay.
So they come with the idea of construction. But then also we find people who don't own land. They would want to buy land. So we have partners in real estate. They are people that we partner with. You give us your budget also, we can source for you land. Number two is if you have land, our first step is to also do a site visit to tell you whether that land is viable, whether it is practical to build in that area. Because also when you buy land, you need to know a lot of details.
Yes.
There is what we call zoning. There are bylaws within the estates. And also there is what we call informal settlement. So when, let's say you want to invest like 10 million, and then you buy a land within an area that is not controlled, we can advise you to either sell that land and buy where you have what you call a gated community to avoid building your very beautiful house, and then now people come and do apartments around you. In another case also, when you want to do apartments, you need to do apartments in our area whereby we have a lot of traffic because of clients and even the target and the niche that you are targeting. So we're able to advise you on those bases.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So if for a young man or a young lady who wants to enter into this business and
yeah.
who wants to become like you, who
yeah.
is looking
yeah,
at
sure.
you as a mentor,
yeah.
what would you tell them? What would you advise them? What tricks and what would you tell them to do?
My advice to young people,
yes.
People want to venture into business. One, you need to be somebody who has a lot of integrity and honesty. You need to solve people's problem. If you solve people's problem, you'll make money. Number two, once you get a chance to serve somebody, it's very important to be honest and truthful. Another thing is there is no easy money. I would tell people there is no easy money. Any successful company that you see, people start from down there. So you don't need to start from top there. You don't need a lot of capital to start any business. So the only thing that I would say is just start small and then learn the ropes as you progress. Once you learn the ropes as you progress, ensure that you maintain the passion and the drive that you end when you're starting that company, and that will take you very far.
Yeah.
Because currently we have people who see successful people and they think that they pumped into success. Success is a journey. Yeah, sure.
So you'll advise a young person to actually work under someone. If I want to get into the construction company, I come and work under you, then from there I can grow my dream. Because squeezy, no one wants to work under anyone. Everyone
yeah.
wants
to start
their own business.
Yes.
So would you advise someone to work under someone first or to just move on with your dream?
It depends.
Yes.
It depends with somebody's passion and everything. But what I would say, if you get a chance to work under somebody, be patient. Because you find you employ somebody today and they want to start their company tomorrow. So we would advise, if you want to progress well, if you're working in a construction company or in any kind of company, take time to learn the ropes. Then you can be able to start your business. Now, when you're starting your business, ensure you tell your employee, I want to do a BCD. Because you see, sometimes there are people who start business thinking that if I work at organization A, And since I was maybe the head of Department B, I can be able to move with all the clients so that I can start my business. You'll fail miserably. So trend carefully, run the ropes, and then you'll be able to succeed at some point.
And maybe last but not least, maybe you can tell us where you're located or where we can find you on your social media platforms, your physical location. If someone wants to reach you, where can we get you?
We are located in Roy Town, a place called Dune Plaza, which is next to Lake Hoy Position. We are just around Kangaroo Road. Our social media page is Facebook, which is Pacific Realty Investment Limited. And then also we have a very active website, www.pri.co.ke. If you want to reach our office, you can reach our office on 0722-111-816. 0722-111-816.
Okay, thank you so much for your story. It's really inspiring, and the people will definitely get back to you. So that was Farason Gishovu, a housing contractor and the CEO of Pacific Realty Investment.